Mark Rogers TV, the voice of college football, talking up some Florida State Seminoles. We got James Coleman on the line, of course, from Fifth Quarter College Football. You can also join James on SportsCenter Live. That's his podcast. So what you do is you just go to Twitter and look up Big Game James 36. Big Game James 36. You get everything you need right there. James, how you doing tonight?
I mean, it's pretty good. Kind of wet and hot in Florida.
Wet and hot.
Springtime, summertime conditions. Our winter seems to be officially over.
That's what I hear. Sweaters. Yeah, we had a couple Alabama people on here in the last couple days. They're talking about 80, 85 here in the next few days.
Yeah, it was definitely 80 most of the day here today.
So the transfer portal finally rose up and bit you a bit, but does it really matter? Can you run down the players and the impact on the squad?
The guy, they had already been in the transfer portal. We made a lot of fuss about Landon Dickerson, a guy in a position that we really did not want to lose. But I think I came on here and I told you guys, if I didn't tell you on Mark Rogers TV, I definitely spoke about it on Fifth Quarter about how this thing really works and how we probably aren't going to lose him. It's just a formality. The young man was exercising his options. But these other guys were in positions of depth. And they weren't getting the playing time or the PT. They did not fit the system. And they used the portal the way it needs to be used. They're getting an opportunity to probably extend their careers. They're very good players for somebody else's system, and I wish them nothing but the best. Like I said, I'm always pro player. It just doesn't always work out at the original school. So good for them.
So we got James Coleman on the line from Fifth Quarter College Football, also his podcast as Sports Den Live, talking some Florida State football. We get James on here as much as possible to break it down for us as no one else can. When you think of spring football, obviously a lot of the things we talk to you about, James, you're going back to what was this game like? What was that like? What was this coaching situation like? What was my positional coach like when they changed or whatever it is? And so we'll throw this out to you concerning spring football. What was your approach to spring football, maybe from a freshman season for you to a senior season? What was the approach around you? What was the feel? Were you excited? Did you dread it? What was it?
It was a formality. I'm not going to sit here and pretend like I like practice. I love playing in the games. Practice, one of those things. Spring ball is an opportunity for you to make gains, get a chance to know the system a little bit better, prove your worth, and for some guys, you know, to get over injuries. A lot of the time, my position was so physical and violent that I didn't participate in spring like how a lot of people did. My freshman year, I participated a lot, very heavy. I was at a position battle. The guy I competed against did not participate because he had a was getting over for most of that spring, and I got a chance to solidify myself and kind of almost and win. I ended up winning the battle after the first game, but I knew I was going to play. I knew we were going to split time. So it was kind of, again, like I said, a formality. My freshman year, I didn't know what to expect. Now it's highly – it wasn't as popular then to have a freshman come in early and early enroll. So your first spring was really after you've played the fall, and it's really just all new experience. And you do really 2 weeks of what they call the official off-season conditioning. We called it mat drills when I played. They call it the chase. They call it a variety of different names everywhere else. But you kind of prove what you want, and you want to get in the best shape, and you want to be able to make the best showing in the 15 practices that you're allowed in the spring ball. But really, it's just a continuation. It's an opportunity for you to win a battle or solidify your position. So there's a lot of position groups where the depth chart isn't 100% set and where the fan base wants to get the chance to know what they're going to be expecting, and there's a lot of excitement. It's kind of like spring in general. Spring is when love is in the air. Spring is when flowers are blooming. Spring is when everything else is so exciting. And then in anticipation for what they're going to do in the fall when, you know, things typically die.